You have. I saved you before. And I'm here to save you again. Not while I'm around. I'll protect you. We haven't much time, so listen closely. There is great potential within you. It comes from that parasite. Your instinct is to resist the power it gives, but you must accept it. Nurture it. I will keep it from consuming you, but for the sake of both of us, you must learn to wield it.
I had the strangest dream last night. There was a visitor promising me protection and all sorts of delicious powers from the parasites in our heads.
Given our shared affliction, I suppose you had a similar dream. Excellent. Now we can see what these tadpoles can do for us. Did you actually want something, or are you just here to spoil my fun?
Darling, I thought you'd never ask.
Lead on.
My apologies. Huh. Not quite myself just yet. I had the strength. strangest dream last night. A visitor came to me. A vision of unparalleled beauty and power. She told me she was watching over me, protecting me, and that our tadpoles could prove beneficial if we embrace what powers they have to offer. An uncanny apparition. Not entirely sure what to make of it. Very curious. In all my readings on the effects of illithid parasites, I've never come across any accounts of correlating dreams between infected parties. Another unique quality of our predicament, perhaps. Are you inclined to take these visitors at their word? Nothing wrong with maintaining a healthy suspicion in such matters. Still, it might be wiser to keep an open mind on the matter. Our visitors' promises of aid might yet bear valuable fruit. With pleasure. Lead on.
Still alive. So that's progress.
Scratched in the ground, as I thought. The creche is nested in the temple below. Did you see? At the mountain pass crossroads. Tirsu's script scratched in the ground. As I expected, the creche must be nested in the temple below. We must go there at once. Githyanki writing. Every word a wheel, every letter a spoke. The most powerful texts are engraved in slate. Some so ancient, only the most erudite Gish can read them. Very well. But promise me we will return before our chance is lost, else I make my way there alone. Lead on, then.
Let's have a look.
A friendly face. Oh, you are a sweet, sweet blessing, my dear. You know, I've had nothing but trouble all day. I've been accosted, chased, insulted. Look over there. Do you see that wretched little hive? Oh, it certainly looks that way. But inside, it is swarming with brutish, stupid, rude Githyanki.
Brutish and rude by your wretched standards. But stupid? Kchoki.
Your charming companion would call it a creche. But it was built on what remained after the Githyanki slaughtered all of the monks. I'd call it a murderous training camp.
Acutely observed on both counts.
Honestly, I was doing them a favor offering to buy one of their eggs. And how am I repaid? Attacked and run off like some transient. What? No, of course not. I was merely... Well... Look, it's just an egg. The Society of Brilliance asked me to acquire one of their roe so they can incubate it and, once it hatches, raise the spawn in their tradition.
Please, do enlighten me. What is this tradition?
The Society believes a Githyanki raised in a peaceful, nurturing environment can overcome its violent nature. I'm sure your friend would agree. A Githyanki is as likely to forsake its violent nature as a gnome is to fly. You've been sipping from the same goblet as the Society. Perhaps you'd be willing to help then. To prove your point, they may have chased me away, but surely the Gith would welcome a person with such sympathetic views to their creche. And once inside, you could simply purloin an egg.
Steal one of Gith's own. I will slit your throat for even suggesting it.
I'm not talking to you. You'll be well compensated, of course. Just bring me an egg. Pity. You'd have become rather rich had you the proper sense. Should you change your mind, you know where to find me.
So, do you have loves waiting for you once this is all over?
You know what? That is not the easiest of questions for me to answer.
You mean just waiting? Like a lovesick puppy? Short-term amusements are much less hassle.
That's enough. On your feet.
Where are you taking us?
If this is about that weapon your friend was talking about, we don't have it and we don't know shit about it.
Silence! Move!
No. No, 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 I'm not going in there. I won't.
Anyone want to join her? As I thought. Through the doors. Now! The captain is expecting you.
The
The Githyanki were fond of the cultists. Could be a good thing.
What do you mean, too drunk? It's not possible.
I can smell the alcohol on their breath from here. Drunk and flammable. What a combination.
To let up. Have to keep going. Won't work.
Feel their anguish.
Nothing will stand in my way. What do I have to lose? Waste a step.
Time to strike. Make way.
Let's go. find a route.
To meet your maker.
Again.
I've missed this.
Can't even catch my breath. My way.
Victory awaits.
Taking a look.
Let's cook with fire, baby.
How much farther can I go? That might be worth a look.
Ready for another round? Knees high.
On the move.
Try something else.
A rough tempest I will raise. Indeed.
Gods, it's hot in here. Ready for this?
respite does wonders.
Feeling fresh?
Into the chase.
Dawnmaster Stockhold. Dawnmaster Stockhold.
Mm.
monastery's notable keepers adorn these intricate panels. The reconsecration of the monastery, conducted by Dawnmaster Seed. Evensong before the Zenith Day, celebrated by Dawnmaster Stockhold. Dawnmaster Vasaid wielding... The rest of the inscription and picture has shattered away. Dawnmaster Welkin Glory beckons forth the rising sun in Lathander's name.